They say bidah divides into two types, bidah in dunya and bidah in deen. That is the answer they give. Bidah in dunya and bidah in deen. We would like to ask them a question. When we say bidah divides into two types, bidah hasana, bidah sayyiah, we say they don't bidah mahmuda and bidah mazmuma. When we say that these are newly invented things, those things that we believe in today, for example, Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, all of this, the compilation of the books of hadith, all of this is an innovation, isn't it? These are all bidahs. But we say that these are bidah mahmuda, these are bidah hasana, these are not reprehensible bidahs, these are good bidahs, these are permissible bidahs. We say bidah divided into two types, bidah mahmuda, bidah mazmuma, bidah hasana, bidah sayyya, a good bidah, a bad bidah. We say that, don't we? What is the answer they give? They say, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, you are adding to the deen of Allah, astaghfirullah. How are we doing that? Where is the addition? You are adding. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, kullu bidatin dalal. Every innovation is misguidance. Since the beloved of Allah said, kullu bidatin dalal. Every innovation is misguidance. Then how can you say innovation divided into two types? A good bidah and a bad bidah. That's what they say to us. How can you add? How can you divide it? When the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, every bidah is misguidance. Then how can you say there are types of bidah which are good and there are bidahs which are bad? When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, every bidah is misguidance, then how can you divide bidah in two? That's the objection. Now we want to ask them the question. Our question is, when we divided bidah into two types, we have the deal for that. We have proofs for that. We do not add to the deen of Allah. We do not add anything. If there is an addition to that addition is made by the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself added it. And that addition is not an addition, it is takhsis, it is specification. Because the term kullu means all. And all is not always all. It doesn't always incorporate every component. When the word all is applied, it doesn't always incorporate all its components. It can be specified. Provided that the specification has been established in the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We say to them, when we say bidah divided into two types, bidah hasana, bidah sayyya. What is the objection? The objection is, how dare you divide bidah into two types? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't divide it. He said, every bidah is misguidance. Now we would like to ask them the question. How can you divide bidah into two types? You are saying bidah dunyaviyya and bidah diniyya. Did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam divide bidah into two types? Did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ever say this? Bidah dunyaviyya, bidah diniyya. By Allah, they will not be able to provide a single evidence from the collection of the books of hadith to prove that bidah divides into these two types, bidah dunyaviyya and bidah diniyya. Impossible. They will not be able to provide that. And even bidah lughaviyya, bidah istilahiyya. This is a concocted terminology. They made it up themselves. This is made up by them. This is not by the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when we divide bidah into two types, that is a division established from the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hadith of Sahih Muslim. An Jarir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam man sanna fil islam sunnatan hasanatan falahu ajruha falahu ajruha wa ajru man amila ba'dahu min ghayri an yanqusa min ujurihim shay'un wa man sanna fil islam sunnatan sayyatan falahu wizruha kana alayhi wizruha wa wizru man amila min ba'dihi min ghayri an yanqusa min awzarihim shay'. Sahih Muslim, Kitab al-Ilm, Bab man sanna sunnatan hasanatan. This is in Sahih Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself said, whoever initiates a new practice in Islam, if it is a good practice, and remember, who will decide whether it is good or bad? It is the scholars, the ulama of the ummah. Ma ra'ahu al-mu'minu hasanan fa huwa 'inda Allahi hasanun. Whatever the believers consider to be a good practice, it is a good practice in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the beloved of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever initiates a good practice in deen will be rewarded. Will be rewarded. And all those who will follow it, the reward will be given to the one who initiated the practice. which itself explains that they are bidahs, which are good bidahs. And again, if someone says, no, 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 this is ihya sunnah, this is reviving the sunnah, this refers to the sadaqah. No one can specify to sadaqah. It has something to do with the sadaqah. Obviously, the sabab, what's the sadaqah? But what is the usul? Again, a detailed lecture was delivered on this issue. Al-ibratu bi'umumi nafsi la bi'khususi sabab. In the light of that usul, I explained that you cannot specify it. You cannot specify this practice to sadaqah, the sadaqah of the companion. And we gave many examples from the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one of which was innama al-amalu bin niyat. If someone today says that innama al-amalu bin niyat is only referring to hijrah, then we will say, no, it's not specific. Al-ibratu bi-umumi lafz, la bi-khususi sabab. And if you don't understand this, listen to my talk on Mawlid al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this does not only refer to ihya al-sunnah and those people who take the hadith from Ibn Majah and Sunan al-Tirmizi. Sunan al-Tirmizi, that in another hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ihya al-sunnah. Remember, ihya al-sunnah is included in this. But it is not specific to reviving the sunnah. Even newly invented practices are included in this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I've explained this in detail before. Now, coming back to the subject. If they say, bidah divides into two types. Bidah hasana, bidah sayyiya. We've got the life for this. The hadith of Sayyid Muslim, the hadith of Sayyid Bukhari, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala said, ni'matil bid'atu hazihi. He said this about Tarawih. The way Tarawih was being performed in the time of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he said, ni'matil bid'atu hazihi. What a beautiful bid'ah is this. Such a great bid'ah is this. So according to the explanation of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, bid'ah is divided into two types. Good bid'ah, bad bid'ah. Good innovation, bad innovation. Yes? And the Prophet himself said, whoever initiates a good practice in Islam will be rewarded. That means a good practice is rewarding. Now we want to ask them. We've given you two dalail. And there are many more dalail to prove the permissibility and this division of bidah, the bidah divided into two types. We say, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Kullu, 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 kullu. The Prophet said, every bidah. Now we want to ask them. When you say bidah divided into two types, now we have the right to say istighfar. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Kullu, 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 kullu bidatin dalala. How can you say bidah divided into two types? Bidah hasan, bidah dunyaviyya, and bidah diniyya. You have no dalail. You have no dalail. And in this, your dalil is your Shaykh al-Najd. And our dalil is Imam al-Mursaleen, Muhammad Rasulullah. Who has introduced this terminology? It is the ulama. It is not the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They accept. So what is the conclusion? The conclusion is that this division of bidah, bidah dunyaviyya and bidah diniyya, this conclusion, this division, this terminology to divide bidah into two types, bidah dunyaviyya and bidah diniyya, this is not established from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is not established from the sunnah of the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So where has this come from? It has come from the ulama. So bidah dunyaviyya and bidah diniyya, this division of bidah itself is a bidah.